Now, in life, we generally have more than just one force acting on an object, so it is very important for us to be able to find and display resultant vectors. You know, we're going to add and subtract vectors. We're going to combine forces on, you know, from many directions on maybe like an object to get it to move or stay stationary. So we need to come up with an idea or a way of showing this addition or subtraction of vectors, both graphically or just simply with drawing, and working with the horizontal components and the vertical components. So I got a couple of vectors drawn here. It's A and B. I've only got two. And there's two ways to draw the resultant vector. Like, say we're going to add or subtract these vectors. One is the parallelogram rule, and one is, I wish I had a name for it. If there is one, I don't know what it is. And I like to call it the triangulate, the, like, sort of like the triangle method. That's not really very good, though, because if you have more than two vectors, you're not going to really draw a triangle. But at any rate, if I want to, say, let's draw vector A plus vector B. Well, if I'm doing the parallelogram rule, that means I'm going to start both vectors at the same initial point. So there's a point. Here is, as best I can estimate it, vector A. Here is vector B. And the resultant is going to be drawn through the parallelogram that I can make with those two sides. So just the best I can here, try and get a reasonable representation of a parallelogram. And then from, you know, I'm going to draw a diagonal through that parallelogram, and that diagonal is going to be my resultant vector, or vector A plus vector B. Well, okay, what if I wanted to do vector B minus vector A? Well, vector B, let's go ahead and draw that first from an initial point. So, somewhere around like that. Vector A, it says minus vector A. Now that means that we're going to go in the opposite direction. It's an opposite vector. It's negative A instead of positive A. So instead of drawing A out in this direction, I'm going to draw it in the opposite direction and at the same length, and let this represent negative A, or the opposite of vector A. I think I did forget to do the little negative sign on the opposite vectors I just talked about a minute ago. And then we're going to draw a parallelogram and draw a diagonal through that parallelogram, and that's going to be my resultant. Now, a couple of things. I could be talking about, maybe I should do a scalar multiple, but one restriction or one thing I don't like about the parallelogram method is if you have more than just two forces working on the same or working in together, if you're trying to find the resultant of more than just two vectors, I find personally using the parallelogram rule rather difficult, because how are you going to draw a parallelogram when you have three or four vectors working together on this particular force or this object? If you want to find the resultant of more than just two vectors, that's going to be a bit of an issue. So what if I wanted to draw the representation of, instead of B minus A, vector B minus vector A, I want to do 1/2 vector B minus A. I want to apply a scalar multiple of 1/2. Well, that's going to take vector B and simply shrink it in half. Cut its magnitude or its length down by 1/2. And again, parallelogram, and draw your diagonal as your resultant. Okay, now I do prefer, though, instead of the parallelogram method, to draw them end to end. So in other words, I want to make, let's see, how about 3A plus plus vector b. Well, 3a plus vector b is going to be take vector a. There's no negative in front of it, so we're going to keep it in the same direction, just make it three times as long. So here's one length of a, two length of a, and there is, the best as I can sketch, 3a. And then, instead of drawing b starting from the same point, I'm going to go end to end and start b up here. So vector b is somewhere around that length. Now, if I wanted to add now a third vector and say, well, there's vector c. Instead of just doing 3a plus b, I want to do vector 3 times vector a plus b plus vector c. And with this end-to-end method, I can just go, well, there's 3 times a, there's 3a, there's b, and here is vector c. I'm going to go back to my initial point, draw straight to my final terminal point, and maybe try and do a straight line, but whatever. That comes out to be this right here. This purple vector is 3a plus b plus c. Let's not forget this is a scalar multiple, and this is the resultant vector. So there is my preferred method of drawing vectors in space that's using, let's just call it the NDF method, as opposed to the parallelogram method. Working with horizontal and vertical components. If you want to add vectors or subtract them, all you have to do is add the horizontal components and or subtract them, and then add or subtract the vertical components. And really, it's pretty straightforward. So we got vector v, it's two, minus 2i plus 7j. Vector w is minus 3i minus 2j. And you can see those again with those pointy brackets, but I'm using the ij notation because my book does. I really prefer the shorthand version of this, but whatever. Find 2w plus 3v. So we're going to do a scalar multiple on w, so it's going to, of 2. So it's going to be 2 times negative 2i plus 7j plus 3 times vector v. Oh, I just got that backwards, didn't I? Let's try that again. 2 times vector w, so it's going to be 2 times vector w, negative 3i minus 2j, plus 3 times v, so 3 times negative 2 I plus 7j, that comes out to be, and you just distribute through the parentheses. So 3 times negative, or 2 times negative 3 is negative 6, 2 times negative 2 is negative 4, and then plus positive 3 times negative 2 is negative 6 I. And 3 times 7 is 21j. And this will have a resultant vector of, let's see, I'm going to add the horizontal component. So negative 6 and negative 6 is negative 12i, vector I. And negative 4j plus 21j is 17j. And so this is how you add or subtract vectors and do scalar multiples with simple drawings going end to end. And this is an example of combining scalar multiples and adding and subtracting vectors in terms of their horizontal and vertical components.